Well, the FBI can't crack the code, but can you? Federal investigators now seeking some brilliant minds to help solve a 12-year-old unsolved murder case. The victim found dead with two encrypted notes, like the one you see here, in his pants pocket. Gregg Jarrett has more live from our New York City newsroom. Gregg?
Well, Meg, this is a murder mystery that has really baffled police. For more than a decade, the answer may be found somewhere in that alphabet soup of letters you just showed written on two pieces of paper. The story begins June 30th, 1999. The body of this man, 41-year-old Ricky McCormick, found by sheriff's deputies in St. Louis. There appeared to be no motive, no suspects. He had been murdered and dumped in this field. The lone clues, two encrypted notes stuffed in his pants pockets. They were a jumble of letters strung together in a long sequence. They made no sense to anybody. Investigators think they were actually written by McCormick up to 3 days before he was killed. Did he know his murderer? And was he leaving clues? Now, take a look at this. This is the first note. Several lines of coded material using a variety of letters, numbers, dashes, and parentheses. According to his family, he had been writing these kinds of notes beginning at a very young age, and it's not really known if anybody ever was able to decipher his coded language. This is the second note. The best cryptanalysts in the country have failed to crack this code. They have tried. And if you want to give it a try, experts say you're going to need to determine the language in the system used, then reconstruct the key and the so-called plain text. Nobody's been able to do it. And that is why the FBI, Megyn, as you pointed out, now asking for the public's help in breaking the code. You can actually go to our website, foxnews.com, check out the encrypted notes there. There is some contact information for the FBI if you can do it. There is no reward except the satisfaction that your brain power might be able to unravel this long-held mystery and, you know, bring a killer to justice. Megyn?
Unbelievable. All right, Gregg, thank you.